What 2012 should have taught you? What 2012 should have taught you? If 2012 has taught you anything, it should have taught you to be prepared for anything. To be prepared for anything. For those of us who have been conscious, who have been quote unquote woke, who have been aware of the present day paradigm, we've been watching what's going on in the world for quite some time now. I've said it before, I woke up in 2009 when I saw the film Zeitgeist, which sent me down a never-ending rabbit hole of consciousness, knowledge, wisdom, and understanding, and esoteric information. And since 2009, I've put in, headed towards 20,000 hours of research. And I've learned so many things, absorbed so much information. And we're going to talk about all that information over these years and over these videos, but I want to focus in on the fact that 2012 should, and we're going to talk about that, that this is actually 2012. Even though it's not 2012, it's there's so many things. Let me digress there for a moment. This is so-called 2020, but there was an error with the Gregorian calendar, an 8-year error, making this technically quote-unquote 2012, which explains a lot of the, you know, ironically explains a lot of the apocalyptic things that are going on in the world today. I remember when 2012 came and went, and it was kind of like, okay, well, what happened? And then boom, this year happens. And then we learn also that this is technically 2012, but actually it's not 2020 or 2012. The Earth is 4.5 billion years old, universe 13.8 billion. And so now let me go back to my other point. What 2020 should have taught you is to be prepared for anything. When January hit, and actually in December when they were talking about the coronavirus over in China, I was paying attention. And I was going on YouTube and pulling up the videos of what was going on over in China, the quarantines, people being locked in their homes, people being pulled out of their homes and thrown into quarantine camps, things of this nature. I was watching that because I pay attention to what's going on in the world. And therefore, come January, when America's still not paying attention to what's going on with the coronavirus, I'm at Costco, I'm at Sam's Club, I'm at Walmart, I'm at the grocery stores, I'm purchasing supplies and goods and things of that nature. I can remember, and I'm sure you can as well, America was not paying attention to the coronavirus and not taking the coronavirus seriously as a culture and a society until that day in March, early to mid-March, when the NBA player touched all the microphones, all the players on the team came down with the virus, and they shut down the game before it started. That moment, and we remember Mark Cuban looking into his phone in awe, in shock. That moment was the moment that America took coronavirus seriously. Not until then, and that was in March. January and February, I was already purchasing goods, purchasing non-perishable items, purchasing toilet paper and paper towels. And so I was prepared. I was prepared because I had 10 years of consciousness before 2020, from 2009 to 2019. And so, again, those of us who are conscious, those of us who pay attention, those of us who are quote-unquote woke or awakened or awakening, participating in knowledge, wisdom, and understanding. We weren't unprepared. We were not unprepared. You know? And so for those of you out there who, you know, were caught out there looking for toilet paper, caught out there in long ass lines that went around the block trying to get goods and services and supplies and food. For those of you who haven't been saving your money, who haven't been investing your money, who haven't been opening multiple accounts, fixing your credit, learning about investing, learning about real estate, learning about putting your dollars to work out there in the marketplace for you. I want to encourage each and every one of you to come into the area of preparation, come into the area of knowledge, wisdom, and understanding so that you can evolve into the area of peace, power, and prosperity. Okay. Also, 2020, in January, I decided to go vegan. Well, I kind of decided in 2019. I said in 2020, I'm going to go vegan. So I went vegan in 2020. What a perfect year to go vegan. What a perfect year to lose 35 pounds. What a perfect year to increase the power of my immune system. What a perfect year to get rid of cow mucus and dead animal carcass. Also went little to no sugar. So no meat, no dairy, and little to no sugar. It's hard to avoid all sugars. And of course, I don't mean complex sugars from fruit. I mean isolated sugar molecules, dead sugar, or simple sugar. It's hard to avoid simple sugars at all costs. And so that, you know, if you pay attention to the China study, after watching What the Health, or even better, Forks Over Knives, you'll see you have about a 5% window of wiggle room when it comes to achieving optimal health and homeostasis. You have about a 5% window. So if 95% of your diet consists of fruits and vegetables, legumes, and things of that nature, you know, health food, real health food, then you have about a 5% window to play with and still achieve optimal health, still achieve homeostasis. And so no dairy, no meat, and little to no sugar. But what a perfect year to do so, right? My finances. I said, I'm going to save $20,000 in 2020. And I've achieved that goal. I said, you know, I'm going to learn more about investing. I'm going to learn more about real estate. I'm going to learn more about building financial freedom and wealth. I've done that. I have major plans for the next 5 to 10 years, financial, economic plans. And so really it's a holistic approach. It's a comprehensive approach. It's a 360 degree full circle approach to peace, power, and prosperity, right? To health, wealth, and knowledge of self. And so, again, 2020 has been, even though it's been an insane year, a year the likes to which we've never seen before, a crazy year, a wild roller coaster ride of a year, and a terrible year for many people. 2020 has been one of the best years of my life. Easy. Easy. Top five. Easy. Because I was mature enough. I was prepared enough, woke enough to be ready for peril, calamity when it comes. You know? If you prepare, then peril isn't as perilous as you may perceive when you're unprepared. You see? And so I just want to encourage, again, I want to encourage all of you out there. Preparation is key. It's a major key to your success. They say success happens when preparation meets opportunity. And so one of the ways that you prepare is by studying. Study everything. Study everything. And for you people who, I see a lot of people following a lot of ridiculous concepts online. Flat earth, you know, a lot of different ridiculous things. And so I want to be careful when I say study everything. When I say study everything, I don't mean follow what everybody else is saying. I don't mean believe whatever you're researching. I mean, when you research and you study, you have to put information up against scrutiny, heavy scrutiny. You know, look for peer-reviewed, you know, well thought out, you know, proven ideas and concepts and facts. And again, throughout the years over this channel, I'm going to go over everything. I've spent 10 years researching information, and now I'm going to spend the next 10 giving all of that information to you to provide value for you as a group, as a society, as a conscious community, as my followers, as the people who rock with me. I'm going to make sure that I provide an extreme amount of value for you through my videos and over these next 10 years. We're gonna come full circle over these 10 years. So if you're a beginner, if you're just coming into consciousness, welcome. If you're someone who is an intermediate, you know, you're mid-level conscious, welcome. If you're someone who, you know, is a PhD in consciousness, you know, someone who's high level, welcome as well. I'm going to, you know, share information with all levels of you out there who are interested in knowledge, wisdom, and understanding, or in esoteric or quote unquote the occult. The areas of information that are needed to build your mental capacity and take you to the next level in life. That's what we're going to focus on here at Black Alien God. I appreciate all of you, but again, before I go, if 2020 has not taught you anything, and I'm sure, I mean, if you look around, 2020 has so many lessons in it. You can't look around or peer around and take a panoramic view of 2020 and not get a ton of word, a ton of message, a ton of gems, a ton of wow. The wow is everywhere. The information, the lessons, the gems are everywhere this year. And we're going to talk about it. We're going to talk about it in detail, especially 2020. I'm going to do several videos on this year. I've been researching the hell out of this year and everything that's went on. But again, if 2020 has not taught you anything, it should have taught you to be aware, be prepared, and be that best version of yourself. Because what do they always say? If you stay ready, you don't have to get ready. So that when calamity hits, you're already ready to rock. You're already ready to go. You're already fortified. You're already certified. You're already qualified for the challenge ahead. And so again, I want to I just want to encourage you with my testimony. 2020 has been one of the best years of my life. And it's because for the past 10 years, I've been studying, I've been researching, I've been preparing so that when calamity came, I was ready. Don't get caught out here again, because this isn't the end. There will be more issues. There will be more challenges. There will be more peril in the world. The world is headed for and smack dab in the middle of a lot of different things going on that are going to shape the next, you know, 1,000 years, you know, from global climate change to the totalitarianism going on in a lot of our leaders globally. You know, globalism, the elite, you know, the drill, artificial intelligence, quantum computing, nanotechnology. These things are going to usher in Skynet, you know, Facebook, Google, Amazon, Tesla. These companies are going to usher in a Skynet. And I'm not saying it's going to be totally terrible, but I'm saying just be ready for major changes within the next 5 to 10 years, extreme changes, you know, from global climate change to technology, to culture, to politics, to spirituality, everything. We're smack dab in the middle of a major shift, and you don't want to be caught out there unprepared. So again, like, follow, subscribe, share Black Alien God videos, because we're going to start a movement, and we're going to heavily impact the culture. And we're going to bring some clarity back to and within the conscious community. Okay? All right, so having said that, I'm going to get out of here. More videos to come. Okay? Until then, peace, power, and prosperity unto you and your family. Black Alien God on all social media.
Pull it up, that's how we ball out. 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 That lake costs $100 bills. I still got more money. Gold all up in my grill. I still got more money. Who cares how you hate us still? I still got more money. Call Jay up and close the deal. I still got more money. My fragrance on and they love my smell. So who cares about what I spend? Still got my mind. My pockets deep and they never end. Still got my mind. I'm going dumb with all my friends. Still got my money. Oh, oh, oh. All I see is signs. All I see is dollar signs.